Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do dragon skin using gel polish and a bit of chrome. Dragons! I'm going to sculpt this nail out and I just need to check how this fits onto the fabulous JJ's nail. And what I'm going to do is get my scissors. I've cut a very, 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 very soft, slight curve. Show you that again. So it's not completely flat. And I'm going to pop that here. Sure. To make this a little bit flatter so it fits a little bit better to JJ's nail. We've got double the thickness here, so it's going to give it strength as well. And I'm going to make sure that's really tight at these sides, yeah?
Oh, it is.
Oh, it's tight. And I'm going to bring the nail out to about 2.5. About 2.5 it'll go to. It's nice and tight. I'm going to dehydrate the nail. When it's dry, it'll go completely matte. So you can see how it's gone matte now. Two coats of primer. I'm going to use Cameo Pink. I'm using Max Adhesion today. I'm going to sculpt out in quite a big bead. And make sure it's nice and neat at the back. So Cameo is quite a pale cover pink and it has a very, very slight shimmer. But all I'm doing today really is building it out, the actual nail. The colour and everything will be created with the gel polish and the chrome. But you can see how easy it is to work with. So I can just create that nail in one big bead. I'm going to pinch this nail. I want it nice and slim. We have got a video all about pinching, haven't we, Adam?
Somewhere
on this channel. So it's nice and set. I'm going to take the form off. So just release that from the foam, and we're going to undo the back. Going to file this with my normal filing routine, and if you are a regular viewer of our channels, you will know what my filing routine is. If you're new and you've never watched this before, my normal filing routine is I go through the sides, we do the sides, yes we do the sides, and then we do the cuticle area, and we don't see it like that normally at all.
No.
Because that was like my mum singing, that was, wasn't it?
That did sound like your mum.
Did I? And obviously this is a stiletto, and we would normally, after doing the cuticle area, we would do the actual shape at the free edge here. But because it's a stiletto, we do that while we do the sides.
Yeah.
I'm doing a stiletto now because I want it to look quite fierce.
Like a dragon.
Because it's a dragon. Fierce. So these dragons on Game of Thrones, are they like really cool dragons?
Yes.
They're still babies though, the ones I'm watching.
Right. So you're way behind.
I am on the second series.
How many series is all this?
Seven.
Seven at the moment.
Wow.
Series 8 comes next.
The dragons time. Have only just been hatched.
Is it all about the dragons? Are the dragons just like little pets, really?
Well, everyone thinks the dragons are extinct.
Yeah.
Ah. I'm just buffing over the nail now, just to make it nice and smooth. Just going to wipe over with pure acetone. Which will smooth the nail even more. And get rid of any little bits of dust. What we're going to do now is, we need black. We're going to apply Serious Black. It's super, super black, this is. It's really, really pigmented. You can see just how pigmented that is. Yeah. I'm going to cover the entire nail. Whoa, did you see that dripping?
My nail literally disappears.
It's like that. I've done yellow with one coat of this. Just check out the pigment on that. Pop me that in the lamp. And now we're going to apply top coat. Then we're going to get some netting. I'm going to hold the netting. Around the gel. Like so. And then I'm going to flash cure this. And take it out. Once we've removed the netting, I'm going to pop that into the lamp and fully cure that now. Now, what we're going to do is, we've got some chrome pigments here. I've got the emerald one and the sapphire one. So, one has a green hue, can you see? And one has a blue
hue.
So I'm going to take the emerald one and rub that in. And then we're going to get the green and rub it down the side as well. And it does surprisingly rub in really easily, even though we've got, you know, that effect on the top. Then we're going to get the blue one. And you're going to rub that down the centre. Just to give it a multi-chrome effect. Dust off any excess. Just check over, make sure you've covered the nail. Just need on the end there. Then I'm going to top coat this. Making sure I cap all those edges. If you don't cap the edges, then you will get a little bit of separation and peeling between the products. You don't want that. Right, what we're going to do now is take a soft file And can you see when you file over that you start to hit those raised sections? And that's all you really want to hit. Can you see? So you need to keep the file very flat. I was tempted to file underneath then. I went into my natural filing routine. And I, no, that's not what I want to do. Use a buffer. Do a little bit of buffing as well. Can you see what starts to happen? It starts to leave a black little design. Where we put the netting will now appear black.
I'm confused by that.
You're confused?
Yeah.
How it works?
Yeah, because the when you press into the netting,
no, it's when she's hold it off.
I pull it, when I press into it and then it cures in the lamp,
mm-hmm.
when I put the netting round it, then I semi-cure it
yeah.
and pull it out, it goes into the shape. In different heights, yes, so
right.
it sort of embosses it.
Sorry, I thought it was the inside parts that were raised up, but it's not.
No, it's the other way around.
Right, okay.
Yeah, so when I pull the netting out, it creates these this little pattern, obviously, that's the same
yeah.
as the netting, and that's when you have to put the chrome on.
Yeah.
See, if you put
that.
It on before, it wouldn't
work. Like
I
said,
yeah.
I thought the netting would have made an indent, not an emboss.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah. Because when you put it on, it just sort of starts to stick to all those little
mm-hmm.
parts and goes up the netting.
Mm.
I'm just going to wipe over, and you'll be able to see it a little bit clearer. Now, don't worry too much if you don't get all the pattern there. Or if you hit the nail a little bit. So can you see that you left with that pattern? It'll show more when I put the top coat on now. I'm just wiping over and checking that to see if I could file any more. And I think I can just do a little bit more here. Ever so gently though. Because you want it to be smooth as well. Because it makes it easier to apply your top coat and get the finish nice and smooth. Because it's going to be, I mean, it's going to be slightly, you know, higgledy-piggledy, a little bit lumpy-bumpy.
It's like distressed, isn't it?
Mm. But when you put the top coat on, you want everything to start to be a lot smoother. Now you can see the dragon scales. That's a pretty cool effect. Pop that into the lamp. And I'll check how smooth it actually is. We might need another top coat on that. So it is actually quite smooth. What I'm going to do now is add some crystals, because what I want it to be is like, as if it's like a, they have like horny things, don't they?
Mm.
Like, no?
Mm.
Yeah. I mean.
I'm just loving the description.
The horny things.
Horny things.
Whips and chains.
Like, not like a unicorn's horn, because obviously they're just the best ones anyway. But, you know, like.
They're not horns, they're like ridges, like spikes
yeah.
on their skin.
Yeah. So I wanted to put something on that's got a bit of a spike to it. So that's why the stones sort of come into play. I'm going to use Mega Gloss to adhere them. So I'm just going to pop that onto the backing paper from a form. Makes it a little bit easier to apply. And then I'm going to use a dotting tool to pick this up. going to pop them. I'm going to pop the stones around the cuticle, so I'm just going to put that into the shape that I want it. Come down a little bit more of that. I'm going to finish this off with a little bit of cuticle oil, and this is Freesia cuticle oil. So there you have it. So it's got like a gorgeous blue sort of lightning bolt coming down the centre of the nail, and then it's all green at the sides. I just wanted it to have that multicoloured chrome effect. Just like, you know, real dragons do.
Like real unicorns as well, and real mermaids.
Of course, yeah. Let me just show you. See, I've got these shoes. See my shoes? Now, I think they look like dragon skin.
They do look like dragon skin.
Some of you might say they look like crocodile skin, but I think they look like dragon skin, because dragons are far more cooler than crocodiles. But this nail is absolutely gorgeous. Wish I had a pair of trainers match that. Oh, I have. So there you are. That's how to create a dragon skin nail using gel polish and chrome. So there you are, guys. I hope you've enjoyed that. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. All the products we've used today will be in the description box below, and I'm sure there'll be plenty of links that you can just click on, so it's easy for you to go and find everything I've used today. I'll see you all in the next video, guys. Bye-bye. This is where you put fire coming out to me.
Don't need to jive for that.
Is this like Game of Thrones edition?